Kitchen. Today we're making broccoli casserole deluxe. And I do have a broccoli casserole in Betty's Kitchen, but it's just kind of a plain variety. And this has a few more ingredients, and I think you'll enjoy having something a little different. So we're going to start with our broccoli. And what we have here is frozen broccoli, and it's chopped. So you need to look on your container to see chopped broccoli, because it comes in spears and in cuts and various forms. This happens to be 16 ounces, and that's what I'm going to use. If I had the boxes, each box is 10 ounces, I would use two boxes. So it could be variable there. Don't worry about matching what I have. I just happen to have 16 ounces of chopped broccoli frozen. I have some water, about 1 cup, boiling over here. So I'm pouring that in, and I'm going to turn it up so it will come back to a boil pretty quickly. And then when it comes back to a boil, what I need to do is let it just cook for about 6 to 8 minutes. So I'm guessing it'll be about 7 minutes, and then I will drain it. We'll go ahead with putting together the casserole. Here's my cooked chopped broccoli. I just got it off the stove and I drained it through this colander and just am sitting it on top of the pan that it was cooked in. It's just going to wait for a minute while we get ready for it. So let's go over here to my mixing bowl, and you'll see that I have 2 eggs that are well beaten. So I just use 2 jumbo eggs, or it can be any size that you want. And then I have some mayonnaise that I'm going to put in the mixture. It's going to taste really good. I always use the free mayo because I like to avoid the fat, and that's your choice. And if you will remember to spray your measuring cup, then that will come out nice and quickly like that. And then I have some onion. Just take a regular onion like this, and all I need is 2 teaspoons that are chopped fine. And that's a situation where if I didn't have any already, I would probably use the kitchen chopper and chop all of this up, and then I would store what I don't use in a plastic bag and seal it and put it in the refrigerator. I cook so much that I would probably be able to use it from the refrigerator. If you don't cook that often, then stick it in the freezer and that would be fine. So I just went to my bag and got out approximately 2 teaspoons, it's 2/3 of a tablespoon, probably a little on the heavy side, but I like the flavor of onion. So you want 2 teaspoons of finely chopped onion. And then you need some sharp cheddar cheese. This is going to be nice and flavorful. And if you don't like broccoli, I think the additives here will make you like it. So we're going to put 1 cup of finely shredded sharp cheddar cheese. Now if yours is coarsely shredded, it will melt just fine, but this makes it a little easier for it to blend into that casserole. Now I have some soup. This is condensed soup, cream of celery. It's just the normal size, 10 3/4 ounces. And I'm just going to spoon that in here. So I've got that in, and there's just one more thing before I mix this in with my broccoli. And this is ground black pepper. You can see from the side, it's just the kind that you would put on your table and shake into your food. So let's give this a little shake, and then this gets stirred around. So here we go. Let me just bring this over here a little bit. And the broccoli, being all drained and sitting there for a while, is ready to add in. Just dump that in. This is a super easy casserole to make, even though I like to call it deluxe because it has some of those extra additives that maybe you wouldn't expect to be in a broccoli casserole. Pretty much everybody knows the casserole where you cook your broccoli and then you melt your American cheese and put it over it, and then you put your crumbs on top and bake it in the oven. That's very easy, and it's similar to what I have, if not the same as what I have as the broccoli casserole already in Betty's Kitchen. But this is going to be much more deluxe, fancier. It will be poured into a baking pan, and here I have an 8x12, and I think that's about the size you're going to need for this. So just go ahead and get that put in here, and you want to spread it out.
That looks pretty good.
Now, I mentioned a topping, and usually broccoli casseroles will have something on the top, some kind of crumbs, and my favorite really is Ritz cracker crumbs. So, and by the way, I just want to say that I use canola oil spray to spray that pan before I put that in, so we don't have to worry about that. What I have over here is a box that has Ritz crackers, and again, my choice was to get the reduced fat variety. And then I want them in crumbs, so I took one of the containers in there. They're in tubes, four tubes. So one tube, put it in a plastic bag, and all of those individual crackers were in there. And as you've seen me do many times, I just use a rolling pin to get those nice and crunched up. And those crumbs will go on top. Now if you want to, you can add melted butter to them. I don't really want to add any extra fat because these are buttered crackers anyway, and so they have more butter than, say, saltines would, so I think they're fine as they are. But that's what it's going to look like. It's going to go into a 350 degree oven, and we're going to bake it for about a half hour. It might be 35 minutes. I'll keep my eye on it, and we'll get it out and show it to you when it's done. My broccoli casserole deluxe is done. It just came out of the oven, and honestly, I only left it 25 minutes because I was looking at it and I could see that it was getting pretty brown on the top, and I did not want it to get black. And everything in it is cooked. It just needed a good mingling of flavors. So it depends on how hot your oven runs. Yours might be different from mine, but I felt like 25 minutes was good. So I'm going to dip in here and show you what it looks like. I just put it on a little serving plate here. I'm going to turn it upside down to let you see the texture, although a lot of it was crumbs there. But that's what the inside looks like. Now I'm going to cover that up with some crumbs so you have a nice portion like that. And then come over here and show you my little place setting where I have a nice glass of fruit punch to go with it and my lovely broccoli casserole deluxe.